Is it too warm though? Is it one of the, is it warm pretty close, or is it, you know? Yeah. I know warm, but this is too warm, kind of thing. Yeah.
You're not well.
Coming down or something. I went to the train station the other day and I said, I'm like a trip to Berlin. He said, you're a star? I said, well, thanks very much, but let's just get the tickets already. I mean, I talk about work, it's that annoying things I find with work, especially like after work when you go to a pub and stuff, is lanyards and high-vis jackets. High-vis jackets generally, I don't think they're a jacket at all, they're just like a camp 90s disco garment. It should come with a white glove and a whistle as well, just in case there's a party that happens to kick off, you're ready to go. but yeah, people, it's really, well, it's a bugbear of mine anyway. People wearing high-vis jackets that you see coming out of their house wearing the high-vis jacket and driving to work and then after work as well. Just leave it till you get to work, because I think you look like a complete nonce. But people just get up, they brush their teeth, they go downstairs, they flick the kettle on, and then they put their high-vis jacket on. They make their breakfast, they sit in front of the television, watching the morning news, glaring off the television with the, you know, neon lights and voluminous yellow. Just like, stop being a dick, wear it before and after that. But you, you see people with their lanyards on, it happens more so in the city, instead of walking to the bar, they're having a good night, they've been there 3 or 4 hours, and they're still walking around with a fucking yang light on. They're desperate for you to say, what do you do for a living? It's like, get a line. Or the little clips that they keep on their pockets as well. It's like they haven't forgotten that it's on. It's because every time they go in their pocket for a change, they scrape a big mark at the side of their arm. So stop being a dick, just take it off. Wait until someone's going, oh, what do you do? Oh, you're, he goes, oh, I'm a technical marketing advisor for property. Yeah, estate agent. Dick, stop being a dick. Wear it at work and then take it off after work. No one wants to know, no one cares. I spoke to one guy, I said, what do you do? Young guy. He said, I'm a barrister. I said, oh, bloody young, quite young. It's like, he must have done the bar, the exams and everything else and stuff like that. I said, what firm do you work for? He said, Costa. It's an hour. Did you fancy Starbucks then? I think parents get up too much as well on their own when like children are out. They think you're not coming home for the night, but you end up staying home. I've got him once at the front door, and I can hear from upstairs, shoo-bee-doo! So I walk upstairs, and in the mirror of the toilet is my mum, butt naked, dripping wet, with a comb in her hand, going, shoo-bee-doo! She says, mother, shut the door! She goes, oh, I didn't think anyone was in. I said, what else do you get up to? friends and stuff used to, you know, when you were younger, you'd wind, I always do it now, I've got friends that wind each other up and like take the piss if they mishear something or, you know. So I'd say, they try and catch you out, like, what would you do if you saw a midget with a 10-foot cock? They'd go, fuck that. You go, oh, you don't care, would you? yeah. Mishearing things. I was out with two of my friends. John has eaten a chicken sandwich and he started choking. My other friend shouted out, give him the Heimlich manoeuvre! He was like, yeah, good idea! The what manoeuvre? Yeah, the Heimlich manoeuvre, give him the Heimlich manoeuvre! He said, I don't like giving him the Heimlich manoeuvre, it's disgusting. Even the hymen is getting behind him like this, trying to break his hymen. It's like, you can't do that. It's disgusting. So instead of helping our friend John out, we just started berating him about the one which I think you find it's the Heimlich manoeuvre and you have to do. And it, oh, John's dead. Sorry, John. I do apologise. Obviously, you'll never do that in real life, just let your friends die. That's a terrible thing to do. If they are joking, give them the right manoeuvre or call the doctor. That's it, it's too hot in here. I can't do the thing straight. Well, thanks so much for coming out. Thank you. this, so we will never forget Mark doing that. It was a great show, man. Boys at the back, thank you very much.
Thank you.